Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial online classes. In this class, we learn about the resolvent kernel. How to find the resolvent kernel of the Volterra integral equation of Volterra integral equation of second kind. So let us see the definition of resolvent kernel. The resolvent kernel is denoted by the symbol capital R of x, t, lambda. Capital R of x, t, lambda. And defined as summation n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda power n k n plus 1 of x comma t. Observe that resolvent kernel capital R of x comma t comma lambda is equals to summation n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda power n k n plus 1 of x comma t, where k n plus 1 of x comma t is nothing but the iterated kernel. Here the iterated kernels are evaluated by this formula. K1 of x, t is equals to k of x, t. This is the given term. And kn plus 1 of x, t is equals to integral t to x. Observe that. Integral t to x. K of x, z. Kn of z, t dz. By using this formula, we find the iterated kernels. And then we substitute that iterated kernel here. We get finally resolvent kernel. So, let us try to find the resolvent kernel when k of x, t is equals to 1. Yes, the first one, given that k of x, t is equals to 1. Yes, k1 of x, t is equals to, this is clearly k of x, t, which is equivalent to 1. By using this formula, k2 of x, t is equals to, integral t to x, k of x, z, into k1 of z, t, dz. By using this formula, kn plus 1 of x, t is equals to, integral t to x, k of x, z, into kn of z, t, dz. So, k2 of x, t is equals to integral t to x, k of x, z, k1 of z, t, dz. It is equals to integral t to x. What is k of x, z and k1 of x, z? Both are equivalent to 1. So, 1 into, again 1 into dz, which is equals to z, limits t to x, upper limit is x, lower limit is t, you get x minus t. Now observe that, therefore, k2 of x, t is equals to x, x minus t. Let us find k3 of x, t. K3 of x, t is equals to integral t to x, k of x, z into k2 of z, t dz. K of x, z is nothing but 1 because of k of x, t 1. So, k of x, z is also equivalent to 1. Let us continue. Which is equals to integral t to x, k of x, z 1. 1 into k2 of x, t is equals to x minus t. K2 of z, t, you get z minus t dz. Integration with respect to z. T treated as constant. Integration with respect to z. T treated as constant. Z square by 2 minus tz limits t to x. Let us substitute. The limits. Upper limit. X square by 2 minus upper limit. X square by 2 minus t into x. Tx minus lower limit t square by 2 minus t square. Remove the brackets and simplify. X square by 2 minus tx minus t square by 2 plus t square. Remember that k2 of x, t is equals to x minus t. So which is equals to x square minus 2tx plus t square by 2. It can be written as x minus t whole square by 2 factorial. What is this? K3 of x comma t is equals to x minus t whole square by 2 factorial. You can write the similar terms. Similarly, K4 of x comma t is equals to x minus t whole cube by 3 factorial. K power 5 of x comma t is equals to x minus t whole power 4 by 4 factorial, and so on. Let us write kn of x comma t, or kn plus 1 of x comma t. Kn plus 1 of x comma t. X minus t whole power n by n factorial. By definition of resolvent kernel, r of x comma t comma lambda is equals to summation n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda power n into kn plus 1 of x comma t. Substitute all these values. Summation n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda power n x minus t whole power n by n factorial. You can write this term as, summation n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda into x minus t whole power n by n factorial. This is a series form. If n is equals to 0, you get 1. If n is equals to 1, you get lambda into x minus t by 1 factorial, lambda square into x minus t whole square by 2 factorial, plus and so on. This is nothing but e power lambda into x minus t. Exponential series. E power lambda into x minus t. Therefore, the resolvent kernel capital R of x comma t comma lambda is equals to e power lambda into x minus t. E power lambda into x minus t. Observe that. So, this is the procedure and way to find the resolvent kernel when the kernel of the integral equation is given. Let us solve the second one also by using same method. What is second one? K of x comma t is equals to e power x minus t. Let us solve the second one. K of x comma t is equals to e power x minus t. K1 of x comma t is equals to, this is nothing but K of x comma t, which is equals to e power x minus t. K2 of x comma t is equals to iterated kernels. Integral t to x, k of x comma z into k1 of z comma t dz, which is equals to integral t to x, k of x comma z, k of x comma t, e power x minus t, k of x comma z, e power x minus z, k1 of z comma t, k1 of z comma t, e power z minus t into dz, which is equals to integral t to x. You observe that minus z plus z cancel. E power x minus t dz. E power x minus t, integration with respect to z, that term treated as constant. E power x minus t z limits t to x. You get e power x minus t into x minus t. This is nothing but k2 of x comma t. K2 of x comma t. Let us find K3 of x comma t. K3 of x comma t. K3 of x comma t is equals to integral t to x K of x comma z into K2 of z comma t dz, which is equals to integral t to x K of x comma z K of x comma z, e power x minus z, k2 of z comma t, e power z minus t into z minus t dz. Again you get e power x minus t, that is a constant term. E power x minus t integral t to x z minus t dz. Integration with respect to z. Integration with respect to z. So you can read that one as e power x minus t into z square by 2 minus tz lower limit t upper limit x. E power x minus t, by substituting the upper limit, x square by 2 minus tx, by substituting the lower limit minus t square by 2 plus t square. After simplifying you get e power x minus t into x minus t whole square by 2 factorial. This is nothing but k3 of x comma t. Similarly, you can write k4, k5 and so on. k4 of x comma t is equals to e power x minus t into x minus t whole cube by 3 factorial. k5 of x comma t is equals to e power x minus t whole power 4 by 4 factorial and so on. Let us write kn plus 1 of x comma t. Kn plus 1 of x comma t, which is equals to e power x minus t whole power n by n factorial. The resolvent kernel is given by capital R of x comma t comma lambda is equals to summation over n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda power n into kn plus 1 of x comma t, which is equals to summation n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda power n e power x minus t into x minus t whole power n by n factorial. E power x minus t is independent of n, so it can be written outside the summation. So which is equals to e power x minus t summation n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda power n into x minus t whole power n. Lambda into x minus t whole power n divided by n factorial, which is equals to e power x minus t into, this is nothing but e power lambda into x minus t. By simplifying we get e power lambda plus 1 into x minus t. A power m into a power n. So a power m plus n, lambda plus 1 into x minus t, which is resolvent kernel of k of x comma t is equals to e power x minus t. As you observe the procedure, and let us solve the third problem. First two finished, third one. Observe that. K of x comma t is equals to e power x square minus t square. K of x comma t is equals to 1 plus x square divided by 1 plus t square. K1 of x comma t is equals to k of x comma t, which is equals to 1 plus x square by 1 plus t square. Let us find k2 of x comma t, which is equals to integral t to x k of x comma z k1 of z comma t dz, which is equals to integral t to x k of x comma z 1 plus x square by 1 plus z square into 1 plus z square by 1 plus t square into dz. 1 plus z square, 1 plus z square cancel. The remaining terms are 1 plus x square divided by 1 plus t square integral t to x dz. This is nothing but 1 plus x square by 1 plus t square x minus t. Now find k3 of x comma t. K3 of x comma t is equals to integral t to x k of x comma z k2 of z comma t dz. K2 of z comma t dz. Let us simplify the integral, which is equals to integral t to x k of x comma z 1 plus x square by 1 plus z square into k2 of z comma t 1 plus z square by 1 plus t square into z minus t dz, which is equals to 1 plus x square divided by 1 plus t square integral t to x z minus t dz, which is equals to 1 plus x square by 1 plus t square z minus t dz with respect to z, and limits are x and t. Simply you get x minus t whole square by 2 factorial. Similarly you get k4 of x comma t, k4 of x comma t is equals to 1 plus x square by 1 plus t square into x minus t whole cube by 3 factorial, and so on. Kn plus 1 of x comma t is equals to 1 plus x square by 1 plus t square into x minus t whole power n by n factorial. Yes, now the resolvent kernel is given by capital R of x comma t comma lambda is equals to summation n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda power n into kn plus 1 of x comma t, which is equals to summation n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda power n into x minus t whole power n by n factorial into 1 plus x square divided by 1 plus t square. This term is independent of lambda. So 1 plus x square by 1 plus t square into summation n is equals to 0 to infinity lambda into x minus t whole power n divided by n factorial. That summation can be written as exponential series. 1 plus x square by 1 plus t square into e power lambda into x minus t. Therefore, the resolvent kernel capital R of x comma t comma lambda is equals to 1 plus x square by 1 plus t square into e power lambda into x minus t, which is the required one. Let us try to solve the following problems. Solve these 5 and 6 and third problems in the same method. You become familiar about finding the resolvent kernel of Volterra integral equation.